in the outer space, even if you are standing in front of the sun, if you see front, there will be darkness, total darkness. You know why? The sunlight requires an obstruction. If you want to see sunlight, it is not visible to naked eye unless it's obstructed. Something hits.
Okay.
Then
it
reflected.
Like prism.
No, no, just even dust. Even dust also. Even if dust is there, you can see sunlight. But not if no dust is there, you cannot see one ray of sunlight. It will be total darkness. That's why in the outer space, always a darkness. So to see the sunlight, you need a reflecting surface, obstructing surface, right? So why I took the sunlight? Because now replace the sun with Atma, the consciousness. Consciousness cannot be seen, cannot be felt, cannot be experienced, okay? No touch is there, no sound is there, no smell is there. It's like sun. The consciousness can be experienced only when the object is in front. Consciousness can be experienced only when an obstructing, reflecting surface is in front. Are you getting what I'm saying? A blocking is required for consciousness. Now, Atma is all alone. There's no other, there's no second. It's only non-dual. So where the object will come? There's no object possible because other than Atma, other than Brahman, nothing is there. That alone is Satya. Where is the star? Where is the planet? Where is the galaxy? Nothing is there. Only consciousness there. The consciousness doesn't know even itself. It's just blissful. That's why it's represented by Narayana, the blissful consciousness. So for the consciousness to appear, an obstructing surface is required, the blocking surface. And the blocking surface has to be mithya or unreal because consciousness only is reality. Right? So for the consciousness to reflect, a mirror is required. Right? For the selfie. So mirror is required, and where is the mirror? It created you. You are the mirror for consciousness. Okay? Consciousness reflects on your mind and you are the mirror for consciousness to see, oh, I am there. You understand? The consciousness to feel that I am there, it needs a reflecting surface which is your mind. Okay?
Consciousness can be reflected.
Yes. Consciousness reflects on a mithya surface.
That is mithya.
On the mithya surface it reflects. Satya nothing is there. So, that's why the word Maya appeared. Mithya surface appeared because Satya has to, Satya is seeing itself. So in any other way, you are the mirror for consciousness. Okay? Are you getting what I'm saying? Now if your question is what is the, why the world is there, why this thing? Consciousness wanted a mirror and you are the mirror. On your mind, the consciousness reflected. And the plants and trees and mountains also reflecting consciousness. The consciousness is Sat, Chit, Ananda aspect. In your mind, Sat and Chit got reflected. Okay? In the non-living, Sat got reflected. So when I say got reflected, the appearance is unreal. The consciousness sees itself in this.
Prabhuji, can you please repeat?
Yeah. Kannada or English?
English.
English.
No.
Ah, okay.
Sir, consciousness of the Vadyo, Chaitanya Pada of your Chidra, Chaitanya Pada just powerful.
Allah, the health, but Yelruku Arta, Galrapa. Okay, instead of consciousness, I should use the word called Chaitanya. Is it okay for all? Okay.
Consciousness is more familiar.
Consciousness is more familiar. Okay. So consciousness or Chaitanya, I'll say. Okay. So see the consciousness or Chaitanya. Okay, I'll give you an example. There's sun in the outer space. Sun. are sitting in a rocket and why? Sun is here behind. Do you see light in front? You can, light. You cannot see a single ray of light in front. The outer space is totally dark. Because to see the sunlight, you need a blocking surface, dust is required, obstruction is required. Then the sunlight gets reflected, otherwise you see only darkness. Right now we are seeing the sunlight outside because earth is blocking it. Right? So instead of sun, you replace with consciousness of Chaitanya. Chaitanya, that's why it's called Atma Surya. It's called Aditya because of that reason only. Aditya is, you have heard the word called Aditya, right? Who is Aditya?
Sun.
It's not sun. So actually that's again colloquial use of sun. Aditya means Adi. One who was before the sun, which is Chaitanya. One who was before the sun is called consciousness. Aditya means he is pointing to consciousness. Aditya also means Surya Narayana, one who is behind, before the sun, which is Chaitanya, which is nothing but you. Right? So that's consciousness. Then the Chaitanya only is there. There's nobody else. It's going bored, if you call this bored, right? Now it wants to see some itself. And for seeing itself, it requires a surface, reflecting surface. Seeing itself, its power and all. So the reflecting surface is nothing but your mind. The Chaitanyam or consciousness is the witness, Sakshi. Sakshi, Brahman, Atma, all mean same thing. So the light from the sun gets reflected on the mirror called your mind. Your mind is the mirror. It requires a very fine polished surface. So now, it's not only your mind, every mind it gets reflected. Sun, animals, ant, amoeba, everywhere, wherever there's a mind, it gets reflection. And that reflection is called Chidabhasa in Sanskrit. Okay? So you can say, your mind is a mirror for Chaitanyam, consciousness. Right? Now tell me, have you seen your face anytime? Huh? Do you have a face? So you have never seen your original face. The consciousness can never see its original face. So consciousness only sees its reflected face. Now it doesn't know its original face. It doesn't know. Consciousness never sees. You yourself cannot see your face. Where the consciousness, nothing is there to see its face. It has never seen its face. And whatever face it sees, it sees me. So there the feeling comes, I am first. Okay? It's like you taking a selfie. See, I am! So consciousness is taken as the first selfie. And the consciousness has not seen its face at all. It cannot see us. So whichever face it says, I am. Monkey is I am. Amoeba is I am. Okay? Lavane is I am. Every face is I am. So multiple reflections happen. Everything is I am. Consciousness says, I am everywhere. That I am is called Chidabhasa. And you see, the I am is capital. And I am in Sanskrit called Aham. Aham is a special word. Aham. We call it Ahankarana. Aham. Aham means I am. So this is a very special word. It has two alphabets in Sanskrit. A, Ha, Mam. Am. A, Ham. A is the first alphabet of Sanskrit. Ham is the last alphabet of Sanskrit at one point of time. So consciousness is saying, Aham, I am A to Z. Okay? A to Z, what else is this? I am. So it sees, it wants to see how much this thing, huh? Everyone, it wants to see his face in so many ways. No wonder you take 10 selfies a day, or 100 selfies a day. So consciousness is taking selfies in all the living beings, and everywhere it says, Aham. So this Aham is called Shakti of consciousness. Right? Are you getting what I'm saying? Shakti. So Aham means I am. So in English that Aham became I am. Aham. So everybody says I am. You say I am. That I am is what you say I am is the consciousness reflecting in your mind. Okay? So the consciousness of Chaitanyam reflecting in the mind is called Aham. Right? So how many places it reflects? Everywhere. Amoeba, bacteria, virus, ant, everywhere it gets reflected as aham. Okay? So now, that's the primary reflection, because the mind is a very polished surface. Right? The secondary reflection happens. Now the aham starts conceptualizing, thinking, oh, what else is there? What else is there? Then the body will appear. Right? The body will become alive now. Body is switched on. The body becomes alive. So you can feel that aliveness in the body. That is the aham's secondary reflection. Primary reflection is the mind. Secondary reflection is body. So, got it? Then the third reflection takes place. Through the eyes, through the sense organs, the world appears. So there are three reflections happening. First reflection on the mind of all living beings. Second reflection is on the body of living beings. Third reflection is on the world. So here in this mind, the consciousness maximum reflection. That's called Sat and Chit. So now this is blissful actually. It has no, it's still not a, this thing. Now it gets reflected on this body. Not one body, many bodies. Right? So consciousness becomes every body, every body. Then the world appears. Consciousness takes various forms. Okay? So then, that's not sufficient. Now the movie has come. But the movie has to be experienced. I want to enjoy this movie, experience this movie. So then, this consciousness which is associated with I am, the capital I am, takes the form of small I am. And it says, I am Lavanya. Okay? I am Prabhu. It takes the secondary, it associates with the body. As the primary reflection, it creates all the world. Everything, all forms are created. Okay? After creating the form, it says, I want to enjoy, I want to see, there is a mango tree, let me see, I am Lavanya. Then she goes back up and picks up a flower. So, the I am takes the form of I am the person. Okay? Then, first reflection is I am. The first reflection is called Chidabhasa, means reflection of the consciousness. Okay? Second reflection is the world and body. So the body has become switched on. This you can feel in your day-to-day activity also. You go to deep sleep where you have got to pure I am. Okay? The morning when you wake up, first just the feeling of I am comes. Oh, I am. Next, I am the body. Next, there is world. So these appear in sequence. It happens very fast. As you become more meditative, it will happen very slowly. You can find the gap. Are we clear? So now, Lavanya got stuck up in this hall. She doesn't know how to go back. So, she can't go back to I. Right? There's no road map. While coming only, there's a map. GPS is there. GPS is missing. So you don't know how to go back because everything, this looks, flower looks so beautiful, the world looks so beautiful, sun, moon, plants, everything looks beautiful and mother is sitting nearby. I don't want to leave your mother, all those things, you get stuck here. You don't even remember that you came from I. Right? Got it. Then this is called Paramarthika Jiva. This is called Pratibhasika Jiva, Vyavaharika Jiva. And then she has a dreams also that I am not sure. What all dreams are? And then dream she takes the form of Pratibhasika Jiva. She keeps on shuttling between these things. Without knowing that I am coming from here, I am going here. I am coming from here, I am going where. It keeps on shuttling minute to minute. You don't even know you are going up and down travel. Solar system, galaxy, everywhere you are going up and down. Right? So how to go back? The going back is roadmap is here only. From I am the body, you have to go to I am. From I am, you have to go to I. That is the technology. Right? So from the world, what has to go back? What should go back actually? Going back, nobody has to go back. Attention has to go back. Okay? So the beauty of attention is, when you pay attention to something, let's say I pay attention to fan, immediately I know there is a fan. Awareness knows there is a fan. So I pay attention to the speaker. So the speaker is coming to awareness. The attention is like the beam in which you see things. Who sees the things? Awareness. Okay, if you had attention switched off, awareness alone is there. So the attention has to travel from the world to the body, from body to Chidabhasa, from Chidabhasa to Absolute. That is the journey. How you came? You go back.
Whatever I have associated, I must not dissociate.
Don't you dissociate, shift the attention. Again, this dissociation concept is also, the more you think of dissociation, it becomes a
Native principle is dissociation.
Native, we keep it lesser. So don't dissociate. Shift your attention. From the world to the body, from the body to the mind to awareness. Shifting. Is this clear? Wrong? So, what exactly happened, you can see here. There is a pure concept, absolute called I. It's called Parabrahma, the one. Here the nature is stillness, total stillness. There's no movement at all. That's why Narayana is shown very relaxed in a middle of the ocean. Deep silence. It's not in silence, stillness. Complete stillness is there. And that stillness, I am appeared. And this appeared. This is at the conceptual level. This is not at taken the physical form. At this level, I am and this appeared. I am and this. This became the world. I am became the individual bodies. So one became two. Two became many. So how many are there now?
One
only has appeared as many. It has not become many. The water only has appeared as ocean. Water, ocean only has appeared as waves. How many are there? If you count the waves, there are not many waves. If you look at the water, only one. So are you looking at the water or ocean or wave? You tell me. Huh?
Water.
If you look back, water, there is only one. The moment you gave attention to wave, many. Water is called Parabrahma Narayana. Ocean is called Vishnu or Bhagavan. Wave is called Jiva. Water, ocean and wave. So by becoming the wave, anything has happened to the water? Nothing happens to water. Water doesn't change. Right? Water is like that only. So, by Parabrahma Narayana appears as Vishnu, appears as many jivas, but nothing has happened. This is called Absolute or Awareness, Supreme Reality. Okay. Only what has happened? The name and form has appeared. So, how to go back? There is many here. The many is called variety, it is not many. There is a difference between variety and many. Okay, how many fingers are there? Five. The five fingers are connected with the hand. There is one hand appear with the variety of five fingers. Like that, one Parabrahma appears as many bodies, mountains, living beings, non-living beings, plants and trees, and there's always only one appearing as many. Is this clear? So from many to go back to two and then go back to I am. So you have to go, what do you have to say? I am not the body, I am that I am, soham. So this actually comes in Bible also. Moses goes on the holy mountain and he sees a bush which is on fire. There he gets 10 commandments. Then he has to push fire. Fire is light. So, what should I say? Whom did I meet? The bush says, tell them, I am that I am. Okay, I am that I am. Word comes from Sanskrit, soham. Soham was me. I am that I am. So, whenever you are speaking of I am, actually you are speaking of God's name. The greatest God's name is not I am. Okay, the moment you say I am the body of Karma Pili. So, I am that I am, or soham you catch hold of, then you go to I am that. Okay? Soham or I am? Soham means I am. So, aham. Saha, aham. Saha means he. Aham means I. I am he. Who is that? Parabrahma, I am. Okay? Not yet. So, from many, you take the root called soham, I am that I am. Then you go to two, which is I am. And from I am, you go to I am I. Sri Ramana Maharshi calls this as I. Ramana calls this as I. Actually, none of the Ramana Maharshi's authors have found out what is this I. I am I, Ramana Maharshi calls this I. So here you become in one with the Parabrahma. So let us, shall we go to go back this now in this room? Ticket? Ticket is there. Shall we meditate now? This is called, this meditation is called Sahaja Samadhi or Natural Meditation. Okay? Sahaja Samadhi is go back to, Samadhi is Vishnu, Narayana. Sahaja Samadhi is naturally you go back. Naturally. Shall we start? Sit comfortably. Close your eyes. Become aware of the vast universe. The vast universe is manifestation of I am. I am manifests as perceptions and thoughts in the form of universe. Become aware of the totality of universe. Huge, infinite space in which stars, planets, galaxies are floating. All this is called physical space or Bhutakasha. It is appearing in my mental space called Chittakasha. The entire physical universe is nothing but an appearance in my mental space called Chittakasha. Bhutakasha is in Chittakasha. Everything in Bhutakasha or physical space, consisting of stars, sun, moon, everything becomes a thought in the mental space, Chittakasha. So there is a thought of sun, there is a thought of moon. The gross object is nothing but a subtle object in the mind. The huge galaxy is thought form in the mind. The attention to the inner space in the body from head to toe, there is an inner space. This is the mental space. Take your attention to the center of the chest cavity. Consciousness, Chidabhasa, in the form of I am. I am is the first reflection in the mind. From head to toe, every cell of your body is filled with I amness, which is Chidabhasa, which is reflection of Brahman. Reflection of pure consciousness, Chaitanyam. Stay in that Chidavasa, I amness. If any thought comes, ask, who am I? Shift your attention to the observer of I am. Right now, focus on the inner space, hold on to the reflected consciousness Chidabhasa, which is appearing as I amness. Any thought comes, come back to I amness, I am I. Any thought or feeling or image comes, again go back to I amness, hold on to that I am feeling at the center of the chest cavity. Overall, from head to toe, this I am feeling is there. Be that I amness feeling. Shift your attention to who is aware. I am aware of the Chidabhasa as I amness. pure eye, the witness is aware of this. I am that awareness. Asato maam sadgamaya tamaso maam jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti 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 lokaha samasta sukhino bhavantu lokaha samastah sukhino bhavantu lokaha samastah sukhino bhavantu hari om shri gurubhyo namaha hari om. Slowly open your eyes. So keep doing this practice. When you do this practice, from I am body, you move into I am. Only when you focus on the inner space, you will get that I am. If your thought is coming, that means you have gone to the body or some other object. So come back to the I am, stay in that I am. Now you have gone one level back, one step back. Where you have gone? From here, I am body, you have gone to I am. Don't even bother, I am body. Just stay in I am. Okay? This I am state is called state of Ishwara, the Lord. If you speak to pray to God, we are praying to the Lord. The Lord is I am. And this is the Shakti. The Shakti flows up into the world. So you stay in the I am and you fall naturally back into I. You don't have to do any effort I as you stay here. The thoughts just dissolve. The thought is nothing but the world, they just dissolve. From I am body, just go to I am, and then there's a thought which happens to I. In the process, what happens? A samadhi state is a state of waking sleep. You are fully aware like a waking state, but no thoughts are there like sleep. A waking sleep is called samadhi. Sleeping samadhi is called
sushupti.
Sleep. A meditation with awareness is called sleep with awareness is called samadhi. Samadhi with unawareness is called sleep. So don't go to sleep and say, I had a nice samadhi. Okay? You have to be fully alert and aware, but thoughtless like sleep. So this can happen if you go step by step. I am body, just go to I am. First you go to physical space, bhutakasha. The physical space, you go to mental space, chittakasha. Then you go to heart space, chidakasha. Stay there. Slowly you start sleeping into pure eye. Now this becomes so this actually slowly becomes a state in the waking state. Whatever you do, you remain that I, pure I, any state. So it's like learning cycling. Initially you do cycling, somebody else hold you, you'll fall back. Then come back again. After some time, you do comfortably cycling. Like that sahaja samadhi, this samadhi practice, it has to be sahaja. You are meeting friends, you are interacting with people, and the background always that stillness of oneness. That's called Narayana. The I becomes, the stillness is called I, which is Narayana. So that becomes manifested in your life. So this practice of Vidhyasana, you keep doing it, then it becomes Sahaja Samadhi or natural state. Any questions? When I speak of Sahaja Samadhi, you should be in a Samadhi or meditative state, whatever you do. It's like a person goes to office, Ram goes to the office, still he is, he knows he is Ram. Ram interacts with the wife, still he is husband, he plays the role, but he is Ram. So Ram has not changed. Your I is never unchanging, I is called Narayana or Parabrahma. That should be your background, anything you do. Is it clear to you? So the simple steps, I am body to, I am that. I am I. Then, sorry, I am I. So that staying that I am I, longer and longer, the deep stillness will grow. And you start experiencing Narayana Tattva in your life, Parabrahma Tattva. You start experiencing your day-to-day interaction, not just meditating. Even in your office, just take a few minutes to go back to. Anyway, you are doing to, when you are going for WhatsApp or Facebook and all, once in a while, go back to Atma also. Right? So many times you are going to check up WhatsApp messages, no? Huh? No harm in once in a while going back to Atma.
Prabhuji, this, I am the body to I am, is the heart space. I am to I am.
Just dumps. There's no path. Yeah. Just
be there.
Soham only. Soham, I am that, I am is also soham. So after, don't repeat the soham. So soham means I am. Just stay in that I amness. Don't have to chant mantra. And suddenly you fall into I. Okay? What is the sign of falling into I? The time disappears, space disappears, you don't know, oh, half an hour over. Oh. Right? Narayana is timeless, spaceless, ageless.
Causeless.
So, once in a while, go. Come back. You can do it anytime. Right? It's clear? Any questions?
Sahaja Samadhi
is, whatever you do, Samadhi practice you do, it becomes natural to you. Natural means, while sitting,
in that state also, walking,
whatever you do in life, still that meditative silence will be there. It's not the, oh, I did meditation for half an hour and then see, my mind is getting running away. No. Again and again, go back to I am. After that, I am becomes natural to you.
You
don't have to close your eyes also. With open eyes, whenever you are there, you feel that. Right? So now this is actually going inwards. Going inwards is you have to go from I am body to I am to I. Now let's take the outer world. Outer. We have two directions, right? Attention is outside. So let us go to outside. Attention, outside. There's an inward journey, there's an outer journey. Okay, what is this outer journey? Close your eyes. Become aware of the infinite space. Gently take your attention to the top of your head. Feel the center of your head, what is called Brahmarandra, the gateway of Brahman. Gently become aware of that Brahmarandra. I am one with this infinite universe. In the universe, there are stars, planets, galaxies, sun, moon, planets, the space, earth, the plants, animals, trees. Everything in the universe is existence, is. The tree is, the sun is, the moon is, the space is, the solar system is, the galaxy is. The isness is called existence. Total. So the existence is called God or Brahman. I am existing. I am means I exist. I means consciousness, am means existence. I exist, I am aware. I am one with the totality of the universe. I exist. I am one with the existence. Existence is infinite. There is no beginning or end to the existence. There is no break in the existence. That's why existence is akhanda. Existence is beginningless, that's why anadi. Existence is infinite, that's why ananta. Akhanda, ananta, anadi, sanatana, timeless. I am one with the existence. Beginningless, endless. Akhanda, ananta, anadi, sanatana, brahma. I am consciousness. Stay in that feeling with a gentle awareness at the top of your head called Brahmanandra. If any thought or feeling comes, again hold the feeling, Shivoham, and come back to the center. I am infinite. I am beginningless, endless. I am akhanda. I am ananta. I am anadi. I am blissful. Shivoham, shivoham. Any thought or feeling comes, come back to that I am center. Shivoham, shivoham. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya pratyorma amritam gamaya. Om shanti shanti shanti. Lokaha samastaha sukino bhavantu. Lokaha samastaha. sukino bhavantu hari hi om shri gurubhyo namaha hari hi om slowly open your eyes everybody got it any point any doubts are there questions are there So any questions? So let us go to, this is called Darpana Prakriya, which leads to Nididhyasa or Sahaja Samadhi. So then second Prakriya, what is called Drak Trashya Prakriya or Seer and See. Drak means seer, drashyam means seen. Drak and drashya. Seer and seen. So here progressively you have to go from the outer to the inner. What is outer? Is seen. For example, I am seeing the wall. I am aware of the wall. But wall is not aware of me. The wall is object. I am the subject. Right? So you have to keep on separating subject and object. The object is always maya or vidya. Suppose I am seeing the wall. If I put a glass, red glass, the wall appears red. If I put a pink glass, the wall appears pink. What is there I cannot understand, that's unreal for me. The object keeps on changing, but subject never changes. Right? So for example, with the eyes, I can see the world. The world has a number of colors. The world has variety, multiple colors. The scene has multiple colors, but the seer eye has only one color, black. From the seer to scene, scene to seer, you start moving, the multiplicity becomes unity. Variety becomes unity. The world has a lot of variety of things, stars, planets, galaxies, multiple colors. From the scene you start moving to the eyes, become aware of the eyes. Eyes are black only, there is no color in the eye. Right? From in variety you have to come back to unity gradually. So from eyes you go back to inside. Okay? Here you have to understand one logic. Anything which is, the seer and seen are always different. Seer cannot be seen, seen cannot be seer. Is it clear logic, good logic? I am seeing the wall, that's why I am not the wall. Wall cannot be I. Right? Seer and seen are always different. Drak and drashya are different. Second principle is seer cannot be seen. You cannot see the seer. You can only see the seen. That means you can only see the maya but not the seer. Sakshi you cannot see. Right? You can only see this seen, you cannot see the seer. That's why no point of time you can catch Atma. Atma is always the seer. Are you clear? Seer cannot be seen and seen cannot be see the seer. Huh? Sakshi, drashya, no, kannu, drashya, no role. Huh?
Seer
cannot role. Drak, drak, no role. Sakshi, Sakshi. Sarina, is it clear? Sakshi, and yen nortene, what I see is object. The seer is the subject. So from seen I have to go to seer.
With the help of mind.
With the intellect, purified intellect. Right? Intellect only is the instrument available to us, there's no other instrument. So you have to discriminate. Anything seen is not me. I am the seer. Seen, I have to move to seer. I am consciousness. How do you go back to consciousness? Eliminate what is seen. Thought is seen, feeling is seen, emotion is seen, body is seen. I can sense the body. That's why, that's not I am. I am not the body, why? I can feel it, I can sense it. I am not the wall because I can see it. Are you clear? So you have to go from the seen to seer. Seen is always Maya, the seer is Sakshi, me, I. So you are, that's how you gradually go into deeper and deeper I. Are you clear? There are three seers in us. Three seers. When I see the wall, my eyes are seeing. The wall is there, eyes are the seers. Kannu. Right? I see the wall, my eyes are seers. Seer number one. Okay? So now, from the object I have gone to subject. My eyes is my subject. I am able to see you. You are object. I am the subject. Eyes are the subject. Number one seer.